Hello, my name is Bill Gehr, spelled G-E-H-R. I have been in the RV industry since I graduated high school. I have written dozens of tech articles for Trailer Life and Motorhome Magazine. I've done DVDs called The ABCs of RVs. I will explain how modern RV refrigerators with absorption-type cooling units function. The black lines are the cooling unit's tubing. The cooling unit parts that are within the red dashed lines are the only parts that protrude into the refrigerated space. Everything outside the red dashed lines can be seen on the back of the refrigerator. We will introduce the liquids in the cooling unit first. Following, we will show the flow of the fluids based on heat being applied to the boiler. Each part of the cooling unit will be introduced as we examine its function. The working fluid is orange. It consists of liquid ammonia, water, and a rust prevention agent. Yellow is the weak solution. It is called the weak solution because it is just water and the rust inhibitor without the ammonia. Blue is the liquid ammonia. Note that in this refrigeration system, the ammonia can be either a gas or a liquid, but the working fluid and the weak solution must always remain a liquid so that the cooling unit will not fail. Boiler. When a calibrated heat source is applied to the boiler, the liquid ammonia boils, creating ammonia gas. The ammonia gas pushes the remaining liquid weak solution up the pump tube. Thus, the boiler performs a distillation process, separating the working fluid into ammonia gas and the liquid weak solution. The boiler is the heart of the system because it produces the refrigerant, ammonia, and pumps all of the fluids. Therefore, the working fluid flows from the holding tank to the boiler to supply ammonia-rich fluid to drive the pump. From the top of the pump tube, the liquid weak solution and ammonia gas are separated into two flows. First, we will follow the liquid weak solution. The weak solution flows by gravity back to the absorber coils. We will return to the flow of the weak solution within the absorber coils. Going back to the top of the pump tube, the ammonia gas rises up to the condenser. The condenser changes the ammonia gas into liquid ammonia by cooling the gas. Please note that it is critical for safe operation that the system be leveled so the liquids can flow down the sloping tubes. The ammonia liquid runs into the evaporator from the condenser. The evaporator is within the refrigerated space. This is where the cooling takes place. There is no difference between water evaporating on your hand and the ammonia liquid evaporating inside your refrigerator. The result of evaporation is cooling. The assistant gas is what facilitates the evaporation. Because the ammonia is heavier than the assistant gas, the ammonia gas sinks down into the absorber coil. Returning to the flow of the weak solution in absorber coil, the ammonia gas is absorbed by the weak solution because ammonia has an affinity for water. Therefore, the working fluid is recombined and returned to the holding tank after the refrigeration process is completed. I've been an RV tech in the RV industry for 46 years now, making me kind of an RV doctor. I would not operate my Norcold or Dometic RV refrigerator without the protection of the Fridge Defend. Visit Fridge Defend by ARP at www.arprv.com and use their Contact Us form to seek answers to any of your Dometic or Norcold questions.